channel. So it's the episode 3 of the Falcon Strategy series. And then if you're not subscribed to the channel or you're new, click that button and let's get to the video. So in today's video, we're gonna be doing the rule of 3, yes, systemizing the last leg of your tree. So let me show you like some examples of different things. So we have three examples here. I'll get to the first one. This one is a ascending channel, and then the ascending channel, the last leg is impulsive. As you can see here, the last leg is impulsive. So if the last leg is impulsive, it may break out of the trend line or ascending channel, and then break back in and then give you that first type leg 6 to 8 hours, or the CM15 type leg, and then you'll be taking it to the downside, guys. So if your last leg is impulsive, you have to wait for movement to get to the downside, break the high maybe, and then get back to the downside. Let me show you like some example of what I'm talking about here. So guys, this is what I'm talking about. As you can see, moving, the price was moving very nicely, and then on the last leg it just started to impulse, and most of the people will just ride out this trade and then leave it. But as you can see, it made like, it went back down and then gave us a mini double top here, and then impulse down, and then on the M15 you will see a nice tight leg so that you can be part of the trade. As you can see here, you'll be entering this trade around here on this type leg here, and then your first take profit will be here or lower. So you are done with the impulsive leg. So let's get to another leg that you can systemize, guys. And then on the next video, I'll be posting how to analyze, like the top down analysis and everything, guys. Oh, let me remove this one. And you can comment if like you have any issues, or follow me on Instagram at BradleyForex_1. So the second one here is the structural approach, guys. So you'll see price moving very nice, giving you good structure, and then reaching like the last leg here, you'll have a clear ascending channel or descending channel with the 1, 2, 3 pattern identification. So on this one, you can enter like at risk entry here, enter trade here. So because you have three confluences, you have this multi-touch identification, and then also you have this one also, yeah, and maybe having maybe a double top. Then on this one, you may take it as a risk entry here, or just even wait for an impulse down here, tight leg, or a hover inside the pattern here. You may have price moving here with low momentum, then you can place your order here, and then you'll be taken into the trade. So let me show you an example of that. So this is the structural approach I'm talking about, guys. As you can see, it moves with structure. Here we have a clear ascending channel, then we have a pattern within a pattern here, ascending channel as a structure, move to the upside. Then you can enter the trade right about Yeah, let me get this, my tool here. You can enter the trade right about here, and then the stop loss just above the structure, just above the structure like this. Just say 20, and you choose, yeah, it's fine. 27, yeah, it's fine. And then you'll be taking it to the downside. Oh, you wait for a type flag here. As you can see, you didn't get any type flag. You got like this type of ascending channel, and then another ascending channel also here. So you can systemize that one as a risk entry list because it moves structurally. So getting in with a risk entry would be a good idea. And then on the last one is a corrective last leg. Let's move on the corrective last leg. The corrective last leg also has like the potential to take you in and take you out just because price is corrective. So as you can see here, you have no clear structure. It can just move up, take you in, take you out, and then just as you wait, you'll get movement to the downside and then a tight flag, then a move to the downside. So I really recommend that you take like tight flags on this one, moving in with risk entries. Location trades with risk entries can be dangerous to your capital. So let me show you in the chart what I'm talking about. So in the chart, this is what I'm talking about, guys. I can take you in, take you out in many scenarios. Yeah, it can take you in, take you out, but you have to just wait. As you can see, price is very, very corrective, and then you take a trade maybe here just because you'll have like an override on the steering here, you'll be tagged out, something like that, and price can just move. I need to show you something. Price can move up to here and then just move to the downside and just give you that commitment or tight leg there, and then you'll miss a good trade just because you've been taking poor trades along the way. So just waiting for this impulse down tight leg. And another impulse down type leg, and then you got two opportunities here to get to the downside. Two opportunities to get to the downside here, as you can see. Let's move. So as you can see here, you had a type leg, you had another type leg. Let me just plot them out. The type leg I'm talking about here. Let me remove these things. So let me just bring everything in here so that you can see everything. You have the first type flag, impulse down, first type flag. If you missed it, you have another one here. So we have abundance of opportunities here, guys. Just that you have to wait for the right time and then capitalize in the market. Another type flag is this one here. Two type flags going to the downside. Then you would have capitalized on this, all of it. And then you'll be banking too much. So guys, thank you for watching the second episode of Falcon Theory, and another one will be posted tomorrow. I think I'll be posting with about maybe analyzing the market from top down analysis and how I simply do my things without any complications of getting my chart